Well, actually, me and Natasha first met Johnny Owen, who wrote it, doing a... What was it? It was a...
It was a pilot called Satisfaction, and we got on like a house of fire, and he was in the progress of writing Svengali. And,
at that point it was still
development,
the short, you know, the online things. And Johnny had had in his mind, he said that he'd wanted to reveal the Prems because he'd been writing about this band, but he'd never shown them. And so he was talking about that, and they were going to do it as another online thing, and then it started to snowball into a film. But he'd always said, he'd always clocked us, and he said he wanted me to be a singer. He kind of wanted to make this kind of super group. I think because I look like Bob Dylan was the main thing that he he hooked on to.
Zimmerman's love child over
here. Yeah, so he wanted to use that. And also we had a massive connection about music. I think our first conversation was about how many Kink songs we all know and remember the lyrics to. So that was how we started. But the soundtrack is amazing. There's a Mott and the Hoople sound called Deep Sea Diver. I know that's a really moving song, and Johnny uses it really well in the film. And also the Jake Bug track, which Jake Bug is huge now, but when Johnny first used that track, Jake Bug hadn't really exploded onto the scene yet. So they really, it's funny that it's taken this long, because they were way ahead of the game with Jake, and I think that's another amazing track on the album. And of course, we recorded a song as well.
Letterbomb,
which we wrote in 3 minutes around the back of a garage on a bit of an envelope, and we recorded it after the film, and they've used it in the actual film at the end, so that's fun. That's my favourite one. A lot of things can just languish in kind of development hell for years and not get off the ground. You hear stories about films that have been 10 years in the process of making and stuff. I think what Johnny was really good at doing was just getting a group of mates together, just saying, let's meet on the Edgware Road or wherever, and we'll just film for a few hours and then go to the pub after. And doing it that way and then getting people interested. You're not going to someone with a script and just saying, do you like this script? You're going to someone with an actual tangible piece of film and saying, what do you think? And it obviously got really well liked, and then getting the likes of Martin Freeman on board to do a little cameo and Boy George. And I think it was really, really clever. He's a good little businessman.
Look at him over there. Look at his little face.